Dear student, welcome to our third session. Now here we'll discuss about the ultraviolet spectroscopy. The absorption of UV radiation by the molecule is depends upon the electronic structure of the molecule. So the UV spectrum is called as electronic spectrum. UV visible spectroscopy provides us the information about the structure of the molecule that contains the double bond or triple bond or conjugated bonds. This spectroscopy can distinguish between the conjugated and isolated dienes, between the carbonyl and alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. It also throws a light on the stereochemistry of geometric isomers and can distinguish between the cis and trans isomers. So both UV and visible spectra are caused by electronic excitation, electronic transitions. The electron can move from ground state to excited state, for which they require some outside energy, and that energy is in the form of light. So therefore the light energy with exact frequency correspond to the energy required to move the electron from ground level to higher level should be used. If we use more energy, that causes the dissociation or the ionization of molecule in the excited state. So UV region, there are two regions in case of UV: vacuum UV and the near UV. Near UV, it lies between 200 to 400 nanometer, that is 2000 to 4000 angstrom unit, and the vacuum UV, it is below 200 nanometer, that is below 2000 angstrom unit. The clear cut distinguish between the near and UV is made because air start absorbing below the 200 nanometer. And commercial spectrophotometer, they contains the wavelength range from 200 to 800 nanometer. That is because the visible light can also acts in the same way as of the UV, that also cause the electronic excitations. The origin and theory of UV spectrum. The ultraviolet absorption spectra arise from transition of electron within molecule from lower to higher energy level, and emission spectra arise from reverse type of transitions. For radiation to cause the electronic excitation, it must be in the UV region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So when molecule absorb the UV of frequency mu, the electron in molecule undergo transitions from lower to higher energy level, and E is equal to H mu. So E total, E internal energy, it is the sum total of electronic, vibrational and rotational energy levels. The energy required for electronic type of excitation is more than that of the vibrational level excitation, and the vibrational level excitation requires more energy than that of the rotational level excitation. So but the delta E or E is equal to E1 minus E0. E1 is the electronic excited state and E0 is the electronic ground state. So actually the energy difference in energy between the ground and excited state of electron, E is equal to E1 minus E0, that is delta, it is also called delta E. E1 minus E0 is equal to H mu. Now let's move towards our most important part, is electronic excitation or electronic transition. The absorption of light energy by the organic compound in visible or ultraviolet region involves the promotion of electron in sigma pi and n orbitals from ground to higher energy state. That means there are three distinct types of electron are present in the organic molecule are sigma electron, pi electron and n electron. That sigma electron, they are present in bonding sigma, they are present in sigma bonds. Pi electron, they are again present in bonding in pi bonds. And n electron, they are unshared electron, they are not present in any bonding, they are non-bonding. So we'll see one by one. Sigma electron, they are involved in saturated bond, they are strong bond, such as found in carbon and hydrogen, in between the carbon and hydrogen of the paraffin. The energy required to excite electron in sigma bond is high, more energy is required, which is more than that produced by the UV light. So compound containing sigma bond do not absorb the UV radiation, so that's why they are used as a solvents. Pi electrons involved in unsaturated hydrocarbon, they are present in trines and aromatic compounds. N electron, they are unshared electron, so this does not involve in the bonding between atoms in the molecule. So organic compound containing nitrogen, oxygen and halogen, they are involved. So N electron can be excited by UV light. Any compound containing nitrogen, oxygen, halogen or unsaturated hydrocarbon may absorb UV radiations. So electronic excitation. Look into the structure of this molecule. Here the black dots represented by the sigma electron. Sigma electron, they are present in bonding between the carbon and hydrogen. The pi electron, they are shown by cross and they are present in the pi bond, whereas hollow dots, they are the n electron, unshared electron. They are not present in any type of bond, they are non-bonded, they are present on oxygen. So sigma, they are present in bond, pi are also present in bonding, and n electron, they are non-bonding. So look into the figure. As we see the energy from sigma electron, it increases to sigma star. So electronic excitation, what is that? Electronic excitation means the absorption of light energy by organic compound in UV visible region involves the promotion of electron in sigma, pi and n orbital from ground state to higher energy state, and this is called a energy transition. These high energy state are molecular orbital called higher energy state are anti-bonding. Look at here, sigma bonding orbital, this is sigma bonding orbital having low energy. This is pi bonding orbital again having the low energy. This is n again non-bonding molecular orbital. So sigma have its corresponding sigma star anti-bonding molecular orbital having higher energy, and pi also having its anti-bonding high energy molecular orbitals. So transition occur from sigma, n and pi bonding and non-bonding orbital to the anti-bonding molecular orbital. So the energy requirement order for the excitation of different transition, here the requirement order is given. N2, look at here, n2 pi star, it require least energy because n are unshared electron, they easily get excited. So n to pi star, it require least energy, then pi to pi star, then sigma to n to sigma star, and finally sigma to sigma star. So molecule present in the non-bonding orbital, they get excited to anti-bonding orbitals. So the wavelength of absorption depends upon the energy difference, that is delta E, is equal to E1 minus E0 between the bonding orbital and antibonding orbitals. Now the relation between the energy and wavelength, both are inversely proportional to each other. From that relation, it is clear that smaller the energy required for the electronic transition, then longer is the wavelength of absorption. Or if it is the higher is the energy required for the transition, then shorter is the wavelength of absorption. And ultimately, if the value of delta E and indirectly the value of lambda max, it totally depends upon the structure of molecule. What is that lambda max means? The wavelength at which maximum absorption occurs. So the value of delta E, that is E1 minus E0, and the indirectly the value of lambda max is totally depends upon the structure of molecule. Transitions, there are four types: sigma to sigma star, N to sigma star, pi to pi star, and N to pi star transition. So we'll see one by one. Sigma to sigma star transition. So here, transition from sigma bonding orbital to sigma star antibonding molecular orbital takes place. Sigma bond, they are strong bond, so they require high energy for the excitation of sigma electron. So that's why, that is the reason. Now I told you about the relation between E and the lambda. As energy is high, wavelength of absorption is low. So example, methane, ethane, they absorb below 150 nanometer, and that's why they are used as a solvent in UV visible spectroscopy. Next is about the N to sigma star. N to sigma star, look at here the sigma and pi orbital. Sigma orbital, if you see the sigma orbital, it is bonded, and sigma star antibonding orbital here, and pi bonding orbital, and the pi star antibonding orbital here. So N to sigma star transition, here N to sigma star transition, N bonding electron, N non-bonding electron are excited to antibonding sigma star molecular orbital. And the example, saturated compound with unshared electron are present, like heteroatoms such as oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, and halogen undergo N to sigma star type of transitions. Alcohols, amine, alkyl halide, thiols, they undergo this type of transition. The transition energy required is less, hence occurs at higher wavelength. Then this type of transitions, if you look at the epsilon value, is very less. Epsilon means the absorption. The absorption value is very less, that's why they have the minimum accessibility, or they have the less importance. So absorption, because the absorption is weak. Next is about the pi to pi star transition. It is called in German, it is for the conjugated system. German word is conjugate, and conjugate KON, that's why it is called as K band. In this type of transition, the electron from pi orbital to they transited to pi star antibonding orbital, and the compound having multiple bond undergo this pi to pi star transitions, like alkene, alkynes, carbonyl compounds, nitriles, and aromatic compounds. Here actually the compound containing two or more double bond, conjugated bond, absorb above 200 nanometer and above 200 nanometers. And in case of N to pi star transition, for aldehyde, ketones, carbonyl, and nitro compounds, the German word is radical. So from radical, it is called as R band. In this type of transition, promotion of electron from non-bonding N orbital to antibonding pi star orbital takes place. Compound containing double bond involving the atoms like C double bond O, C double bond S, C double bond N, N double bond O undergo this type of transitions and require minimum energy, which in terms shows the absorption towards the longer wavelength. That's all about the today's lecture about the electronic transition. Have a good day.